The 1960s. Were a time of change. A time of new ideas.
Tell me that it's evolution.
A time of revolution.
Be a man. Thank God Almighty. We'll be a
change. And a time of taking stands.
Don't you know that you can count me out?
And one of these stands that changed America started in a simple 8th grade classroom. Mary Beth Tinker was a young 8th grader at Warren Harding Junior High in Des Moines, Iowa, who had the courage to take a stand even though the odds were against her. The Des Moines School Board suspended her and 5 other students for wearing black armbands to school to show support for a Vietnam War Christmas truce and bombing halts. Mary Beth Tinker stood up to the school board and said that they were violating her free speech rights in the Constitution. She fought for free speech rights for everyone and took her case all the way to the Supreme Court. It was 1965. The Vietnam War had become the focus of our nation's conscience. American men and women were fighting against communism for South Vietnam's freedom. Many people were proud to be fighting and believed in the cause, while others thought that the war was irrational. Everyone had an opinion on the war, and everyone wanted to express their feelings on this major issue. Mary Beth Tinker, her brother John Tinker, friend Christopher Eckhart, and others decided to show their opinions as well. The Christmas truce and bombing halt that they decided to support was started by Robert Kennedy. The idea of a Christmas truce was not radical or new, and other Christmas truces had been done in previous wars. Alfred Anderson, the last known Scottish survivor of World War I, remembered the Christmas truce of 1914 all of his life as an amazing, beautiful experience.
All I heard for 2 months was the hissing, cracking, and whining of bullets in flight. But there was a dead silence that morning across the land as far as you could see.
He talked about it constantly until his death at age 109. Robert Kennedy's proposal for a Christmas truce was similar to that of the World War I truce. It was a chance for troops to take a quick break from the fighting and enjoy their Christmas. Mary Beth Tinker, John Tinker, and Christopher Eckhart decided to support the Christmas truce by wearing homemade black armbands with a peace sign on them to school. Their parents, being peace activists, encouraged them to express their beliefs.
My parents had a lot of courage, said Mary Beth Tinker. They were spiritual people. My father was a Methodist minister who put their beliefs into action. Brotherhood and peace were ideals that my parents worked hard for, but this did not always make them popular.
John Tinker says,
we had 2 official reasons for wearing the armbands. First, we wanted to mourn the dead on both sides of the war. Secondly, we wanted to show support for Robert Kennedy's call for a Christmas truce.
The wearing of the armbands was purely to express opinions in a peaceful way, Mary Beth Tinker said.
We wanted students at our school to know how we felt without causing any violence.
The principals heard about the plan to wear the black armbands on December 14, 1965, and had a school board meeting on December 21st, with over 200 people in attendance. There were many different opinions, but a unanimous vote of the Des Moines High School principals made it so a new school rule would be created, saying that all students who wore armbands to school would be asked to remove them, and if they refused, they would be suspended until willing to return without them. Earlier in the year, however, a student had worn a Nazi cross to school, and no disciplinary action took place among the school board. However, when Mary Beth, John, and Christopher wore simple black armbands with peace signs on them, then the school board did take action. The schools thought that the wearing of the black armbands would cause distraction and would lead to violence. There was much controversy on the topic of war and peace, and school officials thought that it was their duty to uphold discipline. But Mary Beth Tinker stood up to the school board and said that they were violating her free speech rights of the First Amendment of the Constitution, rights that are inalienable. Thomas Jefferson once said that, "The basis of our government being the opinion of the people, the very first object should be to keep that right." The school board still disagreed, however. Mary Beth Tinker's parents decided to take the school to court and filed a complaint pleading for the school officials and members of the school board to refrain from disciplining the petitioners and asking for nominal damage. The district court dismissed the complaint, but the Tinkers kept going and took their case all the way to the Supreme Court. Some people were against the Tinkers' case. A man on a talk show threatened Mary Beth's father, Leonard Tinker, on the air. Someone threw red paint at their door. Christopher Eckhart remembers there being threats to beat him up in the hallways. The Tinkers got many death threats, but they kept going. Mary Beth recalls,
"A woman called on the phone and asked for me by name and then said, 'I'm going to kill you.'"
Mary Beth Tinker stood up for a cause she believed in and would not sit back down, even when someone called her on Christmas Eve and said that their house would be blown up by morning. Through all of this, the petitioners in the Tinker versus Des Moines case still went to every court hearing and fought for their rights. The Tinkers' lawyer, Dan Johnston, argued Mary Beth Tinker, John Tinker, and Christopher Eckhart's case before the Supreme Court. He accused the school board of violating the free speech rights guaranteed by the First Amendment and argued that the armbands worn by the students were peaceful and non-disruptive.
Number 21, John F. Tinker and Mary Beth Tinker, minors, etc. Petitioners versus Des Moines Independent Community School District, et al. Mr. Johnson.
Mr. Chief Justice, may it please the court.
Now, I would like to make a distinction, if I may, between an expression of an opinion, which might itself disrupt a class, and the expression of an opinion which might cause someone else to disrupt the class. And I believe those are perhaps two separate cases. I'd also like to make a distinction between the expression of an opinion which is coupled with something else, like marching in the hallway, or standing up in the class and making a speech about the war in Vietnam during mathematics class. That kind of thing, I think, the court can prohibit. But we're in a situation here where the record just simply doesn't support that kind of a situation. The situation here, as I view it, is based not so much upon the conduct of the students, whether or not it was permissible, but the conduct of the state, whether or not the conduct of the state was permissible, whether or not in that situation the state can move to subordinate and to punish freedom of expression.
On February 24th, 1969, the Tinker versus Des Moines case was finished, and Mary Beth Tinker won the right to free speech. The Supreme Court ruled that all students have the right to nonviolent, non-disruptive political expression. Supreme Court Justice Abe Fortas wrote the opinion that
neither students nor teachers shed their constitutional rights to freedom of speech or expression at the schoolhouse gate. Speech on controversial issues may start arguments or cause disturbance, but our Constitution says we must take this risk.
Mary Beth Tinker's stand for free speech changed the rights of expression for students all over. Even though she was just a kid, her persistence and courage made it so students all over America can express themselves in a school environment. Christopher Eckhart said,
"What George Washington and the boys did for white males in 1776, what Abraham Lincoln did to a certain extent during the time of the Civil War for African-American males, what the women's suffrage movement in the 1920s did for women, the Tinker case did for children in America."
Because of the stand that Mary Beth Tinker, John Tinker, and Christopher Eckhart made, students still today, 40 years later, have the right to free speech.